Hi everybody, in this video we are going to show how to work with a source control server, with an online service to do source control. We're going to use Visual Studio Online, which provides you a server that can handle up to 5 projects for free, and for more than that you'll have to have a paid account. It's a great solution for small teams that are working together, and larger teams usually have their own team server, team foundation server, Git server, or GitHub. So we're going to put it all there. This is the first time I'm doing this, so bear with me, and we're going to hit all the cracks together. So first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to search for Visual Studio Online. And I think I found this one, so let's go there. And let's sign in. I'm signed in as Noam. Hey, great, get started for free, sounds good. My name is Noam Honig. Let's see if I get that name free by any chance. So it's creating the account. We'll be patient with it. Great, so here we have all of this. So we'll go back to our Visual Studio. And we're gonna click this little button over here. And if you're using an older update of Visual Studios, and just go to Team Explorer and sync, and then it asks you, where do you want to sync to? I want to sync to Public Visual Studio Team Services. So publish to this one. Great. It logs in. It wants me to re-enter my credentials. No problem. Again, we'll be a bit patient with it as it runs through the web and do all sorts of stuff. And then I want to put it on our Honig Visual Studio Online, yes. So here, Northwind Training. Publish repository. Great, it was published. Let's ask it to open it on the web. Okay, so it put it over here. Okay, so we can see our projects over here, Northwind Training. We can see all the information we want. We have Northwind Training in my first project, where everything is in sync. And we can have a look at our INI that we played with. So let's go to the INI. Okay, and we can see its history. We can see the change that I've made. And it will show me the change that was done. Okay, so we have this cool browser where we can see everything we've done, and we can work on this with multiple developers at the same time. And this is great for working with small teams. So thanks for watching. I hope you had patience for all of the little mistakes that I've done. But I wanted to deliver an authentic experience of doing it and work it with it on the web. Just one more thing, just to see if again it all works. So let's go back to Northwind Training and let's go to history. And we can see the commits that we've done, and let's go and make another commit. So let's go to the INI and make another change. Blah blah equals another change to my INI. I'll save it, I'll commit it. And again, at this point, it's committed locally. Only once we publish it to the server is when we'll get to see it on the actual server. We'll go back to the server, hit refresh, and now we can see the new change that we've done and exactly what's going on with it. Now, this is an extremely powerful tool. I strongly recommend that you look at it, investigate, see the different things that it can do. But the biggest pleasure of it is that now you can start very easily with a small team of developers to work with multiple developers on the same code without a lot of hassle. So again, thanks for watching and bearing all the little glitches that I had, and see you on future videos.